So Deep Rock Galactic has been out for over a year now in early access, so it's being built as we speak and as the community's been playing it. And I'm going to give you my Deep Rock Galactic review on what's there now and what's going to be added in the future. Hey guys, it's Chris with BNB Gaming. Welcome back, and I hope you're doing amazing today. Thanks for taking the time to check out this video, and thank you for your likes, your shares. Definitely appreciate it. Now, to start with, guys, what is Deep Rock Galactic? What kind of game is it? I would describe it as a class-based co-op PvE shooter where you can either play solo with an AI companion or with up to three teammates. So basically, the gameplay loop in Deep Rock Galactic is you drop into a randomly generated cave system where you must complete objectives while fighting off randomly generated waves of alien bugs. So in Deep Rock Galactic, you have four different classes you can choose from. Now, each class in Deep Rock has different firearms, different gadgets, and different traversal abilities. Now, each of the classes in Deep Rock have their strengths and weaknesses, such as the gunner has maximum weapon damage, the scout is able to easily get to different areas, the engineer is good at crowd control, the driller can make a path through anything. So all the classes in Deep Rock complement each other and actually encourage you to play together and have different classes on your team. Now, Deep Rock Galactic is currently available on Steam Early Access and also Windows 10/Xbox. And it actually has crossplay between Windows 10 and Xbox. Now, as far as a PlayStation 4 version, Ghostship has said the reason why there isn't one currently is because PlayStation doesn't have an early access program. Now, they haven't said that they are bringing it to PlayStation, but I would assume they are. As far as gameplay goes in Deep Rock Galactic, you have several different mission types you can choose from, and each one feels significantly different. So you have the straight up mining mission where you go through, mine your quota of minerals, and then you have to extract. You have like 3 minutes to get to the drop pod, or you get left behind or fail the mission. And then you have salvage, which has kind of base defense elements in it. You have elimination, where you have to go in and destroy what's called a dreadnought, which is kind of their version of a boss battle. As far as difficulty goes, they have 5 difficulty levels right now. And the difficulty level affects how many enemies, how often the waves spawn, how much damage they do, how much health they have, and their movement and attack speed. Now, as far as character progression, Deep Rock actually has a pretty deep character progression system. Currently, it has a weapon mod system, armor and gear mod system, a perk system, a weapon mastery system where you unlock different skins by unlocking all the mods on a given weapon. It also has class level for your specific class, so scout, gunner, etc. Now, in addition to this, it also has a dwarf promotion system. So once you max out a class at 25, you can choose to promote them again, which will increase your global dwarf level. Now, as far as mission rewards, you're going to earn class XP, credits, and different mineral types as rewards for completing each mission. Now, as far as updates go, as I mentioned earlier, Deep Rock Galactic is still in early access, so it's still being built, and they're actually increasing the price from $25 to $30, and the reason why is they're planning on building out this game much more than they initially intended. So as far as updates go, up to this point, we've received an update pretty much every month, maybe every other month, and they've been adding quite a few new features. For example, this month they added, I believe, 5 or 6 new enemies into the game. As far as graphics go, on Xbox One X, it's 4K HDR, and it's uncapped frame rate on PC. Now, as far as what I like about Deep Rock is it has a really deep progression system. So you level up your class, you unlock different weapon mods, armor mods, it has a perk system, etc. So there's a lot of things to grind for in this game. Another thing I really like about Deep Rock is the gameplay loop. It can go from really casual, where you're just relaxed, enjoying the game, to just incredibly frantic, where these just waves and waves of different enemies come in. And because they're randomly generated, you just kind of never know what's going to be in there. In addition, because it's a survival game, you don't have regenerating health. You have to get health from a mineral called red sugar. which can sometimes be plentiful and sometimes nowhere in sight. That combined with playing with three other people, sometimes they're down, you're the last man standing, you got like three bullets left, and it's just total chaos. I think that's what makes this game really special. Another thing I really like is that it's cooperative, but it's still fun. And what I mean by that is I don't really like games like Vermintide and Left 4 Dead 2 and stuff like that. I mean, they're good games, but one thing I really don't like about them is how you have to share health packs, share ammo, etc. So if you're playing in a group and no one's using a mic, you know, you have the one player that's just using up all the health packs and everyone else is, you know, out of luck. So Deep Rock is cooperative and you do have to find health, but it is fairly plentiful and, you know, you're not going to end up with one player just kind of using up all the resources. So it's a lot more forgiving that way. Another thing I really like about Deep Rock is the shooting and controls is really tight. I play a lot of Killing Floor 2, and one thing about that game is it has that down to a T where it's just really tight. Well, Deep Rock is the same way. The shooting mechanics and just the feel of combat is just really fluid. Another thing I really like about it is that the classes really complement each other, so playing together and cooperatively is easier, but you don't have to do it. Another thing I like about it is each class plays differently. So, you know, after you're playing for a while with a class, you get, you know, like, I need something new. You switch to a different class and they just feel different. They still, you know, you still feel like you're playing the same game, but it adds enough variety to the game to make it interesting. So what could they improve? And actually some of this they have addressed in the latest update. My first thing they could improve is more mission types. Now, Deep Rock Galactic does have a fair amount of mission types, but I feel like it could use some more just to add some more variety. Another thing they could do is add more weapons. Back in December, they actually did add two additional weapons for each class, which for me really improved the game, added more strategy, etc. I'd like to see them do more of that. So finally, what is my recommendation? Should you buy this game, wait for it to go on sale, or just avoid it and go play something else? If you're interested in this game, I would highly recommend picking it up. Now, it has gone on sale a couple times, but even if you have to pay full price for it, I think it's definitely worth it. It has almost monthly updates. It has a good, deep progression system. It has exciting, varied combat, and it's an early access. They're still building it out and making it better. If you're looking for more tips and tricks videos and game reviews, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Until next time, guys, this is Chris. Have an awesome one. Drop it hot.